Hey there, welcome back. Now today we're going to be having a look at a controller for existing AC powered blinds or curtains. So you may have an existing controller that perhaps just had a button on the wall or some sort of outdated controller. Now this Sonoff device allows you to add Zigbee control and functionality to those existing devices. Now, to be totally transparent with you, Sonoff did send this device for me free of charge, but this is not a sponsored video and they have absolutely no control over what I'm going to tell you about it. So this tiny device has a pairing button, it's got a status LED, we've got tiny screw mounts for the cables, and on the rear side we have a QR code. This device can be used on circuits running at 100 up to 240 volts, 50 or 60 hertz, but not exceeding 1 amp draw on the motor. Wireless connectivity is using Zigbee 3.0. Dimensions of the device are a tiny 39.5 by 33 by 16.8 millimeters. Wiring for this device is pretty straightforward, but always get a qualified electrician in when dealing with high voltage power. For the momentary switch wiring, we run a neutral and a live directly into the device, then we connect the motor from the neutral and then to the forward and the reverse section using line out 1 and line out 2. The switches are then independently connected to S1 and S2 and routed back to the live. For a 3-position rocker switch, you would connect the two S1 and 2 to the two poles of the switch. After holding the pairing button in for 5 seconds, the LED started flashing. I then opened up Home Assistant and added it using ZHA, which took about 10 seconds. Within Home Assistant, we can control the motor in a down position. We can stop it or control it in an up position. We can also select over here and select a certain percentage of open or closed. We can invert the operation of the blind. We can also use this device to add other devices directly from it. This is a really good way of making sure that your Zigbee network works as well as it can. So if you had this curtain, for example, in the far side of your house, you might want to connect all further Zigbee devices in this area to this curtain motor rather than letting ZHA decide which are connected to which. Before using the device, you need to do a calibration. This is achieved by holding the device button down for more than 10 seconds. The LED indicator will then enter a breathing mode and the device will automatically control the motor to set up the calibration. There is also a manual process that you can use to do the calibration. Now, unfortunately, I didn't have a blind or curtain to actually try this out with, but I'd be really interested to get your feedback if you've got such a device on exactly how this does work. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.